Hi guys, thank you for joining me. I'm glad all my friends are here today. I hope you're all enjoying your Labor Day weekend. Last day to sit on our butts and relax. There was a magnitude 3.0 earthquake. USGS said it was near Spencer, Idaho, which is along the Sawtooth Snake River Plateau. Here's the location. I'm going to bring it out for you. Show you on Google Earth. Down here we got all the mountains that were blown out. As the hot spot tracked towards the northward is now the caldera. Over here is the Sawtooth Fault Zone. And this is the location. USGS greatly downgraded it to a magnitude 2.6. This here is the monitor at Maple Creek, but you can see down there it came in as a 3.03. More likely, it was probably a magnitude 3.2. But I gave them the benefit of the doubt. I shortened up the seismic wave, and it came in as a magnitude 3.03. Now, we know that USGS loves to downgrade these earthquakes, and they often don't report all the felt reports either. I've shown you that, and I'm sure you guys have sent in felt reports that USGS never reported. I have four monitors here. The one on the very left is a borehole for Yellowstone Lake. The second one over, that's Maple Creek. This here is Little West Thumb. And we got Lake Butte. There was another earthquake. Of course, they never reported it also. And it showed up on all four monitors here at Maple Creek. It came in as red, meaning the computer figured it was close to this location. This occurred at 3:48 and almost 30 seconds universal time. There's its signature. It's slightly smaller. Let me show you this other one. You can see it's got a longer P wave on it. So this one here more likely happened at the park. All right, let me get it. It's got a shorter P wave. That one comes in as a magnitude 1.58. Never reported it. None of these they reported. Only one earthquake within the last 24 hours, and that's that magnitude 2.6, which actually was at least a 3.0. That's the second one in 24 hours, because there was one yesterday. A 3.0, and that was up above. I showed you that. That was actually at the Sour Lake Resurgent Dome. I would not be surprised if it was close to the same location for this earthquake. You notice here, hardly any P wave. And this here is a borehole. Remember, a borehole is a very deep well dug into the ground, so it don't pick up any outside noise or stampeding tourists or traffic. And this is there up by the fishing bridge, the village there. That's where this monitor's at. This here is the monitor from Little West Thumb. Again, yeah, a very short P wave. 1:38, another very small earthquake marked in red. This is Little West Thumb. There's the spectrogram. Yeah, we got blobs of magma that came in later. Look at that. But we want to go back up to this one. You can see we got a series of drum beats through here. Let's look at the spectrogram. Let's see how big that was. A magnitude 1.39. And these are harmonic tremors. Here's another one. Just after midnight, universal time. 53 minutes and 55 seconds. Marked in red. That comes in as a 0.96, but let me show you what I did here. Because we had blobs of magma coming in, so I took that all out. I probably should have left it in. At Lake Butte, they only have one marked in red, 3:21 and, 5 seconds or so. You can see here as the magma came in, it popped the ground. I've talked about how brittle that ground's getting. As the magma rises, and magma naturally wants to rise up, kind of like a beach ball filled with air, held underneath a body of water, it naturally wants to rise. Yeah, look at that. This is all today. Look how wide that line of melt. Melt is pockets of rock. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. And this is what the borehole for Yellowstone Lake was showing when I pulled the files. Let's go to the spectrogram. Yeah. And this is what it was showing earlier. Yep, volcanic tremors. These are volcanic tremors. What are volcanic tremors? Do a Google search. A volcanic tremor is a continuous seismic signal that lasts several minutes to days in duration. It is observed during volcanic eruptions or sometimes independently prior to an eruption. Most volcanic tremors are represented in a restricted frequency range of 1 to 9 hertz and with a wide variety of emerging patterns. Here's a paper, I'll give you a link to it, about volcanic tremors prior to an eruption. This was a volcano in Japan. The signal was detected for 2 days from July 29th to July 1st at stations near vents. Now this one had frequencies between 1 to 6 hertz. The largest amplitude was observed at the end of the tremor activity, 2 days after the onset of the eruption. The burst of gas slug at the surface vent may be a reasonable model for the generalization mechanism of the violent tremor and the occurrence of impulsive infrasonic signal. Now this is about phreatic eruptions. Phreatic, relating to or denoting underwater in the zone of saturation beneath the water table of a volcanic eruption caused by the heating and expansion of groundwater. So we got between 1 and 10 hertz. You can see that here. And let's go to what it was showing when I pulled the files. Yep, between 1 and 10 hertz. There's its signature, what's going on. Oh, I'm off the line, sorry. Now again, this is the borehole for Yellowstone Lake. Let's see if I can make that signature right there a little bit bigger. Remember, I've showed you this over and over. For those that have followed me, they're probably getting tired of seeing this. Shallow volcanic earthquakes. And then we got harmonic earthquakes too. So what do we have going on at Maple Creek? This is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Yeah, there's some little quakes there. What hertz do we have? 1 to 10 hertz. Little West Thumb. This is what it was showing when I pulled the files. And I want to go to the blobs. The blobs of magma. That's their actual scientific term. Blobs of magma coming in. Let's look at the signature. Yeah, 1 to 10 hertz. Lake Butte. This is what it was showing when I pulled the files. We got two lines of melt. What can I say? I'm speechless. Another 3.0, which they downgraded. Everything is not A-OK. Let's make that bigger. Can I make it bigger? Yep, there you go. That's when the blobs of magma were coming in. See how they're rounded at the top? Yeah, volcanic tremors. There's a rumor or a story going around the internet that supposedly some information from the government, they're expecting Yellowstone to erupt, what, in May? By May of next year. Have you guys heard about that? Oh, yeah, the camera's acting up once again today. Someone asked me about the two lines of melt and what it meant, etc. I think we got cracks, or what's called dike intrusion, coming in at two different levels of the fault system. See there? So we got a crack where the magma's coming in and flowing out sideways, horizontally. I've talked about that before. It's got a cap of rhyolite, so the magma can't come up through the surface. So it's kind of like being stepped on and squeezed out horizontally. And then it found another way to crack the surface, come up through a dike intrusion to another zone of melted magma, and it's being held down by that hardened cap of rhyolite. Think of two plates of glass and putting a liquid between the two plates of glass, and it oozes out sideways. That's probably the best way I can explain what's going on here with the two lines of melt. So this is Little West Thumb. Let me jump around. You can see the two lines of melt. Kind of settled down there. I'll go back a little bit farther where you can see it a little bit more. See that? And then earlier. Each line is a half an hour. And this here is Lake Butte. This was earlier. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Yeah, look how thick that's getting there. See, we got two lines of melt. This is the swarm program. It was developed by USGS. They know exactly what is happening there at Yellowstone. People were asking how I get the data. Is it publicly available? Only if you download it. You got to go to the stream view from Gemesis. I know I'm pronouncing it wrong. You go into manage sources or add sources. And see, these are all the different monitors. So we add a source. Let me show you how I do this. IRISDMC. Then you got to go manual. Ask for a full list of monitors. Now all the boreholes are down here at PB, right there. These are all the boreholes, see, B005, and you come down to whichever one you want, and the one I'm using here at the top is 208, okay, and then 950 is another one for Yellowstone. And then you can also go down here to WY. Let's see, WY. And these are all the other monitors they have available. Moose Creek, Idaho, Denny Creek, DD. Now that's near Grant. EE, I think that's the entrance for the east. Old Faithful, Horse Butte, Holmes Hill, Hawks Rest, Joseph Cote, Little West Thumb, Lake Butte, Maple Creek, Mary Lake. Mary Lake's kind of interesting to watch. When they have a large earthquake, the magma sloshes back and forth underneath Mary Lake. It has a very interesting signature. Can't think of what MP. Madison River, Mount Sheridan, etc. Purple Mountain. Upper Falls, Western Boundary. Anyway, so you just click on that, and then it'll show you, like, whatever. And then you can either use, I always go ENZ or HHZ. Now, HHZ would be to pick up for long-distance earthquakes, where EHZ or ENZ would be for only local earthquakes. So I use all EHZs. You can see them all over here. That's what I use. But anyway, so you download the program. Let me close this out. close that out. And then you take a section, you highlight it, you go up to section, save file, and then you save it. And then you go over to this program, let me show you, which is Swarm, and then you go to File, Open File, and it'll show you all the data that you downloaded. And you gotta go by one and click on it and upload it. And then after you do that, it'll show you a list of the different monitors, and you gotta click on each one to open it up. And, you know, I resize them to fit them all into my picture. Yellowstone monitors for the earthquakes and the spectrograms, they're not publicly available, where you can just go to a web page and look at it. You actually have to do a lot of work and download it and then open it up. And I've been slowly showing you guys how you can figure out the magnitude of the earthquake. You go to the signature and you figure out where it probably started, and then you got to go down to where it looks like it probably stopped, and you mark it in two little green spots. Now this one here, I really shortened it up, but that's how I came up. This one here is magnitude 2 point whatever. So if you want to go through all that work and look at the earthquakes and figure out the size, USGS has been really shortening up the signature. So sometimes what I do, see how it's shorter? I'll look at the gases that came up, and then I'll go to about where it ended, the gases. And you have to start in a spot before. So now I got a 2.23 on this one. And I always give links to these programs if you want to download them to your computer. So anyways, that's all I have for you right now. If you have any thoughts or comments or any more questions, please put those down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe. And I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.